Hello and welcome to UiPath Studio, the professional development tool for robotic process automation, or RPA for short. Today, I'm going to show you how to build your first process automation using UiPath Studio. Before we get started, let's have a quick look around. The Tools tab is the place to go to install extensions that enable UiPath to automate many common application types. For example, to automate web applications, you'll need to install an extension for your browser of choice, like Chrome, Firefox, or Edge. If you use Internet Explorer, no extensions are required. Okay, let's go back to the Start tab. From here, we can open existing projects stored locally or on version control systems. With a click, we can open one of the most recent projects, or we can create a new project from a template. For our purposes today, let's start with a blank project. We'll give it a name and click Create. When the project finishes creating, we can see this main screen. To get started, let's open the main workflow. And this is the designer, basically the canvas where we'll add activities. The activities are the building blocks of any automation. An activity replicates a manual task that you perform on your computer, a click, a selection, or anything like this. I can either click the plus button here and search for the activities that I want, or I can browse the tree here to drag and drop them. In our automation today, we're going to get text generated by a secure password generator site, and we're going to enter that into Notepad. As simple as that. Let's start by opening a browser using the activity with the same name, which needs to be added to the canvas. Notice that it's asking to insert the URL. Since we're using a fixed string, we'll put it inside quotation marks. It could have been a variable here. We'll see what that means in a minute. Over here in the Properties panel, we can configure how the activity is going to behave. Notice that the panel is already populated. The URL entered is here, and the browser type can be changed here. If we don't specify one, it will default to Internet Explorer. Let's use Chrome for today. Remember that for Chrome, the extension has to be installed. In our case, it is. Next, to get the text, which is a secure password that's being generated by the site, let's add a getText activity. It's going to ask to indicate the element inside the browser. Clicking this minimizes Studio, and the application behind it, which in our case was Chrome, is brought to the foreground. When we hover, it's identifying the various UI elements that it can interact with. This is a getText, and we want to get the generated password, so we'll choose this field here. All right, now that we've got the text, let's store it in a variable. The output field in the Properties panel is exactly for this. But first, we must create it. There are multiple ways to create variables. In our case, let's use the Variables panel here. We'll call it password. It is indeed a string, but its current scope is the do part of our workflow. We will need it outside of it, so let's expand the scope to the entire sequence, where we will add new activities. Now that we have the variable created, let's add it as the output of the getText activity. All right, for the next part of our automation project, we will interact with Notepad. We'll input the value that we've extracted from the website into Notepad. First, let's add an open application activity and click Indicate. It's not Chrome, so we'll use Alt-Tab to bring Notepad into focus. Only then we can indicate it. Studio will figure out the path to Notepad, so it can launch it directly for future automation runs. The final step is to input the password that we extracted here into Notepad. To do that, we'll add a type into activity. And when we're prompted to indicate where the text should be typed, we'll just point to the main text area here of Notepad. As for the text to be added, we'll input the name of the variable. As you can expect, this will in fact bring the value stored in the variable. And we're done. Let's save this. To run it, we'll click the debug button here in the top left. If everything goes according to plan, we'll see Chrome being launched, and then the notepad will pop up with the password typed in. If we compare the two values, they are identical. So, everything worked as I expected. It's that easy to create an automation using UiPath Studio. If you'd like to learn more, navigate to the Home tab and then to the Help tab. Here, you'll find links to many resources, including product documentation with step-by-step tutorials, and our academy with free courses. And that will help you learn more about RPA development. And that was all for today. Thanks for watching.